going on, boys? Man, so this is gonna be a different video. What is
water guy?
Man, so definitely a different video. I got some splaining to do. I filmed this video over the weekend. It's not the weekend anymore, it's Monday. And I didn't know that the sound wasn't working on my camera. Real big bummer. So I was gonna do a voiceover. I tried to do it, just didn't sound good. So basically I'm gonna walk you through what that video was about. And it goes to show you always need to double check your work or something like this will happen, because now I need to buy something for this car until I can drive it again. So to start off, what I wanted to accomplish on Saturday was installing this. This is a side skirt seal, side skirt trim piece. The one on my driver's side had a tear in it, and it's just one of those things, every time I got in the car, I was there, I saw it, and I'm trying to restore this, you know, to the best of my ability, and that was one of those things that just always caught my eye, and it was annoying, and these are cheap enough where I didn't really have an excuse not to. So, first thing I'm gonna do is, I guess I'll flash that. Take off the side skirt, take off that seal, and replace it. Taking off the side skirt's easy. There's pins on the bottom of the side skirt that you removed. You pull out the little piece of the pin, and then the rest of the pin can be pulled out. For some reason, the front of my side skirt has two self-tapping screws, which definitely aren't supposed to be there. So someone has done something to this car before. Then what I found works best is the seal doesn't adhere to the car itself. It adheres to the side skirt, so there's nothing to peel off of the car. The best way I found to get off the side skirt is to pull from the bottom. There's a little rail on the side skirt itself that clips into the clips on the car. None of the clips that I have on this car broke. Generally speaking, if something's going to break on this car, it will pretty quickly just because this car is so old. So I think those clips, I think you're meant to pull from the bottom to get the side skirt off. But that's what worked best for me. So then once the side skirt was off, I wanted to clean the side skirt area of the car. So I used some Simple Green diluted with water. It's probably 50-50. I cleaned it a couple times, and then I went back and used some spray on wax because I don't know if it took off any layers or anything like that by using Simple Green. So I sprayed it back down with spray on wax, wiped that off. So then moving to the side skirt, that peeling off the seal was super easy. But if you've ever debadged a car, peeled off any seals, done anything with wings or anything like that, the residue or the adhesive it left behind, you basically, you're gonna commit your fingers to being blistered to remove that. That's just, there's no other way around it. The best way I've found to remove that type of adhesive is to just continually just pick at it with your fingers or rub your finger over it as hard as you can to get it off. I've tried tar and bug remover, I've tried Simple Green, I've tried Goo Gone, I've tried all that stuff, and nothing works as well as just sacrificing your fingers. That's basically what you're gonna do. So that's what I did to remove that. Then installing the seal, super simple. The seal isn't cut to measure. It's not the exact length, so you will have some extra. There's a little lip on the seal that rests on the top of the side skirt. Super easy to install. Super easy to install. Once you get that in, then you can literally just pop the side skirt back into those clips, put the clips that go on the bottom side of this guy's side skirt back on, and you are good to go with putting the side skirt back on. So if you're new to the channel, one of the things I wanted to do to this car, one of the things I did do, was suspension coilovers, replace the brake rotors, brake pads, and brake lines. I have roughly 100 miles on the car since I did that, so I wanted to go through and double check my work. I wanted to make sure all the bolts looked good, nothing was leaking, everything like that. I probably should have noticed this before, maybe when I got the suspension done, I probably should have noticed this, but I just didn't. So starting on the back driver's side. That's perfect. Nothing's leaking. Everything looks good. Moving up to the front, though, you'll see here in this next clip, take the tire off, and there was definitely some rubbing from the tire onto the shock tower or the spring, and it wore down, like, it wore the paint down. I don't think that's that big a deal, but more so what it did is really, really wore the inside edge of these tires. These tires are already pretty old, so I don't really feel comfortable driving on these tires with that amount of wear on the inside of these tires the way they sit now. You'll see the driver's side is not that bad. It's bad, but it's not really bad. Once I get over to this passenger side, take that off and show you that, you'll notice where it was worn or where it had been rubbing on the shock tower or the coilover. It was pretty deep in two areas. And again, I don't think it'd be good to keep driving on these tires as they sit. The rears were fine. I should have ultimately seen the fronts and known they were rubbing, but I just didn't catch it. So I either need to get spacers for these wheels or just get new wheels and tires, which is what I want to do anyway. So that kind of brings me to the wheel and tire discussion again. You know, do I want to go OEM style? Do I want to go OEM style 24 wheels? Or do I want to do something a little more aggressive, like some BBS LMs or something, you know, some Apex wheels? I kind of don't really want those because everyone has them. But anyway, I want your thoughts on what to do with wheels. Also, I know we have a few new subscribers here that are interested in R8 content. I may have some stuff coming up for that, so stay tuned on that. It's kind of a toss-up. I'm trying to decide if I want to sell it or make it rear-wheel drive. So there's a rear-wheel drive kit for this car. It's fairly cheap. I wouldn't do the install on that myself. But overall, the mod itself is supposed to be amazing for the car, and it would be a supercharged V8 R8 that's rear wheel drive. That would be an absolute gas. That would be so much fun. So let me know if you want to see that content or not. But again, sorry for the weird voiceover style video. It goes to show that you always need to double check your camera equipment and you need to double check your installs, because things get messed up that way. So, if you're new to the channel, smash that subscribe button. Not all videos are like this, I promise. Should have some more stuff coming out for this M3 for sure. Keep me updated on what you want to see with the R8, because again, I know there's a few new subscribers here that want some R8 content. So if you think making this thing rear-wheel drive would be something you're interested in, drop a comment down below, I'd love to hear it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you next video. Peace.